What's up, everybody? Welcome to a very special episode of Keith and Mike Watch. Now, normally, we are reviewing episodes of Deep Space Nine or Playmates Star Trek toys, or custom Star Trek toys. But today, as a bonus episode, and this is also available in its original form on your YouTube feeds, but this is a bonus episode of a lost episode of Star Trek The Next Generation. Mike, did you know that there was a lost episode?
We have been talking about this neon years, I think. I'm sure you mentioned this eons ago when I first met you. And we've teased it on the feed quite a bit. So I'm excited to bring it to our patrons first and to the rest of you guys out there on YouTube eventually.
That's right. If you're on this, patreon.com/KM for all of this bonus nonsense. But let me just tell you a little bit about the missing episode of Star Trek The Next Generation entitled Star Trek The Wrath of Neener. Now, Mike, do you know what Neener means?
It's funny. My family has its own Neener lexicon. I doubt it's the same, and so I'll let you fill us in.
Yeah. Well, Neener arrived in my life from by way of my younger brother, who we took a road trip out to Yellowstone from Vermont, which is a like 4 or 5 day. And my 7-year-old brother decided to take it upon himself to regale us on this road trip over days with the beautiful sounds of Neener, 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 Neener for hours on end.
As you do.
To which I would reply, "You're doing it just to annoy me. I know you." So that is where the title of Neener comes from. It's not actually an integral part of the plot, but I felt like it needed to be explained. So also to be explained here, and this is definitely very much a canon film.
Okay.
This is
good to know.
Part of the Star Trek lexicon. So this episode was filmed in my basement in Vermont in, I'm guessing, late 1991 or early 1992, based on some reference points on the film itself. And this was written, directed, and starring 11-year-old, 12-year-old me. So kind of a big deal. And why was I so into it? Well, my uncle was working on the show at the time. So when this episode debuted and my family, for reasons beyond my understanding, thought of it as a comedy. When it's not a comedy. I mean, there's some funny moments, right? But this is a very serious, action-packed episode of Star Trek. But they found it so successful that my uncle did take it back to Los Angeles on VHS and showed it to the producers, including Rick Berman of Star Trek, because they were actively filming The Next Gen at that point. So I don't know why it never aired, because I feel like, you know, it gave Berman the episode. I don't know why they wouldn't take the opportunity and air it. This would have been...
Let's look at a couple of possibilities, you know.
Yeah.
Right now, the big hotness in TV and media, Keith, is taking old properties and giving the old reboot. So who knows? Mm-hmm. Once this hits the YouTubes, you might be getting that phone call any day to reboot this as its own series.
I suppose. But I don't know why it would need to be rebooted. It's flawless, Mike.
I'm very excited. I can see in the logo there, you're wearing some sort of a visor. So it looks like there's someone. Are you playing all the characters?
I don't know how you were able to tell that it was the same person playing multiple characters because of our flawless portrayals and costume designs. So this is my younger brother, Scott, and myself, amazingly Mike Myersing our way through this entire...
It's shocking how similar you look. Shocking.
I can't see it. It looks flawless to me. Mm-hmm. I'm pretty sure that's Patrick Stewart right there in the middle there.
Let me just say to all of our patrons and to our YouTube people just finding us on YouTube, just before we just revel in the glory that is everything Keith that we're about to explore, I want you to know that when we started podcasting together 3 years ago, there is no way on God's green earth you would ever let me, let alone the internet, watch this. So the sheer growth, Keith, and death of your ego, and perhaps your id entirely, is really glorious.
I think it's more about giving up. But
quitting.
I will say that, okay, so both of my brothers are part of this production. And my my younger brother, who starred in it with me, said, it's fine if you put this out there, but I don't necessarily need to be tagged in it. So so there it is. I'm sure he will be watching this.
Not Paleface Sound.
No. This is Scott, my younger brother, who I did this film with. Mm-hmm. I would also like to point out the contributions of my mother, who occasionally ran the camera when we needed three people. But so definitely a big part of this. But my older brother, who also subsequent to the filming of this, went on to also work on Star Trek and did the sound effects for Star Trek. So what we're watching today is my George Lucas version of the original one, which I cut together and added some effects to, mainly because after every take, we rewound it and watched it to make sure it came out well. So it was pretty incomprehensible by the time you saw it. So I edited it all together, and I gave it to Sean, my older brother, who went back into the original archives for the Next Generation sound effects, because he was working on Voyager or Enterprise at this point, and edited this episode as a real episode, as appropriately, because it's a real episode, naturally, as a regular episode of Star Trek The Next Generation. So do enjoy all of that. So I think there's plenty more to talk about after we watch this, but I think we should buckle up and take in the full extent of Star Trek The Wrath of Neener, written by, directed, starring myself and my younger brother, Scott, with post-production by my older brother, Sean.
This has been sitting on our YouTube in preparation, and I have diligently avoided it.
Like, have you not watched it for real?
I have not watched it. Swear up and down. Cannot wait to find it. It's like, I'm very excited.
Now, you know, I'm going to give you one last piece of information.
Okay, please.
Before we begin this. As the tyrannical director that I was, I mean, look, if you want to get a product this good, you got to break some eggs, right? You got to be clear and direct about what you want. I did not trust Scott, my younger brother, to know when to cut, right? So, because look, it's single camera.
You just yell
right?
cut a lot?
I did not yell cut, but what I did was completely indistinguishably, unnoticeably to anybody but a true professional, would tell Scott to cut the camera by doing this.
Make it so.
So I would nod to Scott that it was time to cut. So at the end of this, we're going to have a super cut of those. And I'm not sure you're going to be able to tell that I was telling Scott to cut, because it was pretty flawless and indistinguishable. But anyway.
Okay.
So buckle up, kids. Let us see.
World premiere!
The world premiere of The Unseen. Only about 12 people have seen this in the entire world, including the producers of the original show.
There we go.
Star Trek, The Wrath of Neener. Grab some popcorn, kids. So this post-production is clearly like a 1999 as opposed to 1992.
Yeah, but the sound already is awesome.
Oh, yeah. I think this was Windows Movie Maker that I cut this together with.
Oh, Scott gets top billing, huh?
Well, I didn't want it to seem like a vanity project.
God forbid.
Yes, YouTube, we know we can't monetize it.
We're aware.
The music.
Whoa! Careful now. The drama. Oh, crap.
It's not a comedy. This is a drama, damn it.
You know, in such a short time frame, 6 minutes, you really have to get right to it.
Yeah, you really do.
Night watch, day watch.
First line got cut off. Don't worry about it.
Anything to report, Mr. Warp?
No, sir. Mrs. Kabruski broke her arm today while playing on the holodeck.
Mr. LaForge, head into the nebula. Path impulse.
Scott is Geordi. Special effects were very expensive.
Oh. It's so lifelike.
Klingons? What do they want with a nebula? It could be a perfect place for a space station.
I should point out, that's a bald cap I'm wearing.
Well, I don't sense anything but the ship.
Scott also plays Troy.
But what would the Klingons...
I'm sorry. There's been something wrong with the screening.
I'm sorry. I'm sorry. Can we catch that entrance again? Did you intend for this to be screened through, Keith? Because I now need to stop.
No. I feel like it is available, folks. If there's a link below, you could watch it without us talking over it.
Is that a toy he's wearing on his face?
That is my mother's hair band, literally taped with scotch tape directly to his face.
Well, I don't sense anything. Well,
Keith, try not to laugh.
That's true.
And failing.
So now hold on. Before, let me. One of my favorite things in the world, okay, and I'm so happy that you do it right here, is to watch inexperienced actors. Mm-hmm. When they know their co-actors' lines. So let's rewatch this scene, and I want you to, instead of watching the Troy talking, I want you to watch Keith, who is micromanaging his brother to the extent where he's just lipping his lines.
Well, I don't sense anything but the ship.
I'm still known for that.
With a nebula.
I should also point out two things in that shot. Scott's wig was a snow garter they just put over his head. And B, you'll note at the end of any shot where both of us are in it, I have to stand up and walk as part of the blocking. But to cut the camera, so that's why I'm always getting up. Anyway.
Could you fill us in on what we've missed in the first 30 seconds of plot?
We have gone into a nebula, right? And, oh, shit, there's a there's a Klingon warbird there in the nebula.
Oh, yes, we saw that.
And Troy did not sense anything from the ship.
We're going to... Get away from our nebula.
We come in peace.
Get away from our nebula.
Joe and Joe, Captain.
We're not going anywhere.
Captain, we're being attacked.
Huge budget.
Laser sounds. Look at you. First of all, freaking adorable. Second of all, can we just... This is pre-green screen days. This is, for any kids watching at home, you've got your fancy streaming computer. This is what we had. We had Keith under a red tablecloth? What?
Oh, Mike, that wasn't me. I wasn't going to.
Yeah, of course not.
I was going to make my younger brother do it. So that.
But Keith, if I'm going to be under here, can't my face just be seen? No.
No. Your space. Be space.
Could we get a black blanket to indicate that it's space?
We don't have a black blanket. We have a red one. It was already on the couch. That's what we're using.
All right. Can I make the laser sounds with my
mouth? No. Well, I'm pretty sure that we did. All the sound effects were done in post like 10 years later. So it's the George Lucas version.
But the SFX you did here, or the
No. All of
effects?
That was post. All the graphics are post.
That was good.
Also, 10 years later.
Just random creatures, right?
They're Klingons. Obviously, they're Klingons.
You couldn't get a better take? I mean, he's clearly laughing. I need a little more drama. I'm going to need a little more
drama. Mike, we got the takes we got, okay? It's a complicated piece of layer need you to of the
look,
character.
I'm going to need you to look scary as the bad guy.
That's not the bad. That's Troy.
Oh,
did
I'm
you
sorry.
Not see him take the phaser out of Troy's cleavage?
No. Sorry.
And did you not tell the wig? The perfect wig? I don't know how you could tell it wasn't anybody
but Troy.
Let me get
the cleavage reveal again. I forgot. Little boys love a boob reveal.
Didn't quite understand how they worked, but... That's Troy.
Yes.
Now shooting a Klingon, obviously.
Oh, what a great death.
Dr. Crusher, to the bridge.
Oh no, Worf's been shot.
Some of those legacy sound effects made it in there.
Worf's alive! Now he's gonna fight.
Whoa! Hey, this is better than some of the Trek action sequences I've seen.
Yeah, no doubt.
The slow motion actually really helps.
Yeah, well, that's all the Lucas part.
The sound effect, he really did a great job.
Obviously, the most fun part was the fight, so we did it twice.
I need to get sports in there.
You got a better performance second time.
We did all that choreo.
Yeah, I mean, we practiced. Oh!
Good comedy beat.
That was easy. Jordy, I think it's your turn.
What was he eating?
Gum. Jordy wants fresh breath. Oh, there's original Charlie in the background.
Hey, you think we can finish this up before I die? Right?
The director made an appearance.
Right now. Your filmmaking, it was very meta, Keith.
There it is! We beat the Klingons!
We were successful. Just straight up recorded the television to get the outro.
You darn right we did. You darn right. So now, don't worry, we're going to have credits for longer than the actual
episode. Yeah, that's the best
episode.
Part. Yeah. Not worried about the focus.
What's that? It was a blooper reel, of course.
You guys must have pissed yourselves watching this for days and days.
Oh my god.
He's really enjoying that gum.
Yeah, he really is. Well, he's got a lot going on there. He's got a gum, he's got a visor, he's got a phaser. That was the sound the phaser actually made.
This is the only episode you guys ever made, huh?
Why would we need to make another one?
You're
it's
like,
so
this
perfect.
This takes so much time.
I mean, this was, it was kind of perfect. You don't need to make a Godfather 2. You nailed it the first time.
Yep.
So, now, of course... Because of all of the emotions you're feeling, I want to give you some time to really process them through the credits here. And here's all of the you won't be able to tell, but this is me telling Scott to cut.
It is subtle.
Was very serious.
Well.
Yeah.
And
there it is. Our last cut.
I have some notes.
How could you? It was flawless.
Number one, that started a prolific content creation career on its sure on its did. Way. You know, the plot's a little hard to comprehend, but I feel like we enter
layered.
Yeah, okay.
No, it's layered because they go into a nebula, they discover that there's Klingons there. The Klingons do not come in peace. They don't want them in the nebula.
Okay.
And so then they beam aboard and then they murder all of the Klingons and then that's it.
Yeah, the murdering part seemed pretty clear.
Yeah. Well, that was really the important part from the standpoint of 12-year-old me.
Now, Keith, and I mean this with love, there were times when I felt that your younger brother had more acting chops. So could you explain what he's gone on to in his career?
Well, I mean, first off, liar. I was playing, look, he got more of the character roles. They're a little showier.
That's fair.
But I was playing Picard, right? Yeah, and you could tell by my flawless,
And voice alteration? Was that, so you were, what was, how did that happen?
That was done by the Emmy-nominated Star Trek sound effect designer.
They took your actual voice and then modulated?
Yes. Anyway, so I was playing the more pathos, more he got to play the character beats. He got to play the comedy. So anyway, but he has, of course, gone on to a storied career as a hockey goon, and now is he's a scientist. He's a molecular biologist. Because he's the smart one. And I do these YouTube videos. Anyway, continue.
So excellent job by the Varney brothers. I felt that the costume design was what I would call frugal. And I think that really helped on such a tight budget.
Sometimes working within limitations really help you make the most of your creativity. Mm-hmm. It's, like in Jaws, right? The shark didn't, the fake shark didn't really work. So Spielberg was forced to, with that limitation, focus on suspense, focus on not revealing the shark, making the shark in your mind is scarier than what is on the screen, and sort of invented an entire suspense genre. And our limitations here were, we didn't want to go upstairs and find other things. We just took whatever was already in the basement as the
costume.
And
you're using one of those big over-the-shoulder type VHS cameras, yes?
A VHS camcorder, that's right. It was a Panasonic, yeah.
Which was cool because while it was recording, you could hit pause and then unpause, and you could create some sort of disappearing type effects right in real time there.
No, we didn't do that. We cut and then walked away and then cut again. So, which is why the George Lucasing of it all made much more sense. We were able to do the beaming effects and everything. You know, the very best that 1999 could create for
us. Yeah, I mean, the best 90s bit, the best DIY part of that, being serious for a moment, is I remember any type of thing we would do at Halloween or anything we'd record on audio cassette or video cassette, we would always, clearly, because so many fun things would happen throughout, we would do always a blooper reel. But then
of
when
course.
You watch it like 25 years later, out of context, you're like, well, where's the funny bit? What's the blooper? Because it was a memory that's not actually captured on video a bit.
Well, the blooper part of this is how seriously I was taking it.
I mean, that seems to track, Keith. I've met you.
No, it 100% tracks. Like, everything about that part of it is, it explains everything I do in my entire life. This 12-year-old me is not any different than I am now, except I don't need my own bald cap.
No, and so, you've got your straight-ass teeth now because, as you could see, we were dealing with some braces issues at the time.
Oh, I had crazy braces, yeah. But, I mean, Picard and Worf had braces. It was a directorial choice.
Oh yes. Well, let me ask now that we're staring at young Keith there.
Yes.
And here's adult Keith. Keith, I'm going to ask you a question, and this is on behalf of your mother, who I'm sure is watching this.
Oh, without a doubt.
Keith, I spent all of that GD money on braces. Are you wearing your retainer?
Short answer? Hell yeah, I am.
Hear that, kids?
Long answer, it's a TMJ retainer, but it's not for keeping my teeth in place. It's for
Is it molded?
My jaw, but yeah.
Okay, well, then it counts.
Yeah, totally counts. Totally counts. Yeah. So, yeah. But with what they spent for orthodonture was unbelievable. Anyway, so, yeah. So that's Star Trek The Wrath of Neener, folks. Any constructive criticism you can leave in the comments below? I mean, it's perfect. So I don't know what you could possibly say, but it's... Rick Berman, why you didn't air this? I don't understand.
Well, you know, Keith, we have looked at people's custom toys and marveled at them. We have seen this work of art, and we've been on a podcast with a fan film creator. Maybe there is something to the idea of exploring other fan-made films to juxtapose, compare, and contrast to The Wrath of Neener with, of course, with permission of the creators on their YouTube channels. Yeah. But maybe we could do a little cross.
I would love to do that under the following stipulation.
Okay, I'm ready.
I want to see the fan films that you made younger than 20.
Me? Mike and Deglio?
No, well, definitely yours. But okay. Also, the collective you. I want to see your Star Trek fan films you made
Links below on YouTube.
If you put it there, we will review it because
absolutely.
That's
or so any much weird fun. Home video of you with Star Trek on the TV in the background.
Nope, that just gets uncomfortable. It has you have to be the Star Trek. I don't want to see your home movies. Definitely don't want to see your home movies, but I do want to see your Star Trek.
Really degraded quickly.
I shut that down. Boom. No. Anyway, so if you would like to retroactively support the budget of Star Trek Wrath of Neener, you can join our Patreon at patreon.com/KM, spell out that and you get bonus material like this. Unfortunately, I do not have a follow-up or a sequel, but maybe we'll do one ourselves. So,
I'm so happy that what existed on a VHS, which could have been lost to antiquity, Keith, has now been digitized, redigitized, put onto YouTube, so it is forever now.
It is forever. Unfortunately, it will follow
it
me
is
the
now
rest
expressly
of my life.
Owned by Google.
It is owned by Google, and and Scott is untagged. All right. Well, we will see you back here in your feed with more other nonsense. Thank you for watching my greatest cinematic achievement.
Oh, that was wonderful.
Check out our Deep Space Nine show. Check out our Star Trek toy show. And till then, this has been Keith and Mike.
Watch.